All right, let's step into the AVO operations room. This is where we conduct our monitoring of our real-time data coming in from our remote stations. This is showing a webcam located here in Anchorage, and it's pointed at Mount Spurr. If you come over here, you can see another part of the operations room where we're not just looking at the number of earthquakes being located, but we're looking at the seismic data itself. One of them that we're looking for very closely at AVO is called volcanic tremor. Volcanic tremor is a long time continuous shaking of the volcano for minutes, tens of minutes, an hour, even longer. If we see energetic volcanic tremor begin beneath the volcano, then that will be a signal that the volcano is progressing even closer to an eruption.
Yeah, so this is the TEFRA lab, and we want to be able to get as much information from that ash as we can about the volcano. This is a sample that actually fell in Anchorage in August of 1992. And if you look really closely, it's a very coarse-grained ash. It's very gritty. In some ways, this is not as bad for your health as a lot of volcanic eruptions, because the grain size is coarser, so it doesn't get into your lungs, and it's not quite as hazardous. However, we've also been looking in our archives and from samples that people had given us over the years from the 1953 eruption, and it's really fine-grained and really powdery. And this stuff would get resuspended more easily, it would get into your equipment more, into your house more, and also potentially be more dangerous for your lungs. So we're looking at all of these old samples to understand a range of what Spurr can produce to help people prepare.